I thought we should be staying together for the kids, but we can't. Even they know.
I will never let you bother. I said, when you come close now, baby, you can give me goosebumps. I just wanna let you know.
I'm gonna get my brains fucked on Saturday night.
Excellent. And while you're planning that out, I'll be picking our daughter up, who's been waiting for you for 30 minutes.
I'm just saying, you know who you are. It's a vibe. It's the return of the Mac. R.I.P. the Furl. I promise you ain't nothing like these L.A. girls. And we can sip Slurricane listening to Earl. Who knew we bring the bay to the world? Love letters to you hit different than any shit I wrote. I sent flowers to your office, hope you get the note. I put an inside joke between us right there in the quote. I'll sing your praises all day, I'll hit the Whitney note. Cause you're my queen, all that I need, yada that I mean. Yada that I mean.
Now is a frequent face. It is Robin C. Adams, and he brought two incredible people with him. Robin, welcome once again, my friend. How are you?
I am back like I never left.
Like I never left. You actually stay here overnight, right? I do. Every night. We just don't want anyone to know.
They've got a couch for me in the back, and it's very comfortable.
So we have worked together for a long time. Yes. You are an icon in our television industry, but you brought two amazing humans with you today, and you're all going to be talking about getting messy. What's going on with this?
Well, I was introduced to Messi through a good friend of mine who's a casting director, who are friends of theirs. And she said, I've really got a great series. It's funny. You should put it on Footprint Network, the network I co-founded. And I just said yes, because, you know, in the industry and the same with you, when somebody says, oh, I've got it. Oh, yeah, let's go. Yes, because I know it's great. Took a look at it and literally was laughing out loud. And so we're going to air all five. In fact, all five episodes are airing now on Footprint Network on
Wonderful.
The Willie Fist channel.
Wonderful. Kate, what's your background? What's your experience with this project and in general?
So I identify as an actress, and my life was kind of going through this little change. And I know they say write what you know, so I got my laptop out and started writing what I know or knew. And my marriage was falling apart, but it was very civil. It wasn't like your typical, like, you know, angry husband and wife.
Like a segue in music, right? Something's kind of winding down.
Yeah,
and then,
exactly. The right. fire was burning out.
Okay.
Right? So then there was, you know, friends influencing me to try online dating, which I did. And some was great, some was really bad. And you'll see some is great and some is really bad.
I had a really bad online date once. And well, I shouldn't say really bad. It was just, we went out for sushi. And, you know, sometimes people eat sushi and it's okay to eat it with your hands. But this guy was so gross. And there was really no way around it. Like, Ugh. You know, like, there was like one of those moments where you're like,
that's a no-no.
I can't even look at this person when he's just like eating the sushi. And Robin and I are friends. And I think I even called you. And I said, okay, this guy, I don't even know what to do, right? But sometimes in life, it gives you content, right?
Yes.
So how did this collaboration start blooming together?
Well, we had a reading. Okay. I had a reading. I invited Nicole to be one of the friends, one of the actresses, characters. And she, at the reading, was laughing so much. I said, she gets it.
Yes.
She gets it. And then we went out for a coffee, something like that. And I asked her to direct it because I knew she got it.
It wasn't even on the phone. It was in real life. It was more magical than that in a way because as I was sitting there, I could see the whole thing. I could see the film of it.
Okay.
I could see the resolution. I could see the lighting. It just happened. And I've directed before.
Yes, you have. You have a wonderful...
But not like a web series. And I kept hearing, I want to direct this. And I thought, shall I tell Kate? And I didn't say anything. And the next day you called me.
Right.
And you said, do you want to direct this? I was like, okay.
Yeah.
The law of attraction is working.
Yes, it does, right? Yeah. When I really truly believe that. When you're born creative, we just think different. We have the ability to kind of like subliminally get things going and we don't even know. And then the universe somehow conspires for what's in our best interest.
Yeah. If there is no contradictive element in it, if we're not thinking, oh, I could never do that, then there is a block. But if you're just like, I really want to direct this, and it was open channel and it happened.
It happened.
Yeah, it was fun.
Now, Robin, with all of your expertise in running networks and shooting television, what was it about their episodes that you found the most joy in?
It was the realness
okay.
of it. You know, when you're on the planet for as long as we have been, you meet so many different
people. Speak for yourself.
Except Nicole,
right.
who was only born a few years ago.
And she goes backwards like I do, right? The time machine goes this way, right?
Exactly.
But it was the realness. I consider myself to have a sense of humor, and I was literally laughing out loud. And I always say, you know, if something could make me laugh out loud when I'm sitting by myself and there's no one else around, then it's funny.
Okay.
And every time I watch it, I laugh out loud.
And it makes that mark. You all three are so accomplished. Can you pick out one thing in their past that you're joyful about?
Ooh,
just one. What's the first thing that comes to mind for each of you? And I'm putting you on the spot, I know.
I did HBO's Deadwood.
Okay.
That was a pretty cool experience.
Okay.
The Wild West.
And how about you, for you?
Well, I'd say my three kids.
Okay.
Oh. I didn't even think
about that.
So it's not a professional thing.
It's not professional.
Okay. My daughter Lisa's hair is a lot like yours.
Right? Oh,
doesn't she have a
really?
Lisa's hair? Oh, yeah. Oh. She's got this naturally curly, like, bouncing, like joy in her hair.
Nice.
Robin?
I'd have to say the day I picked up the phone, when people actually answered phones, and called CNN
okay.
at age 17, asking for a job, that changed my entire life, my entire career. Even, you know, to my young daughter that I have to this day, everything happened.
Because of that call, that one call.
Wow.
Amazing.
Sometimes I learn something new from each different person that I interview. And a recent guest said, shyness can cost you money, right? And haven't we all at this point in our journey, especially in television and film, learned that, right? Those moments where we doubt ourselves, where we think, oh, well, it couldn't be me, or, you know, oh, I can't figure out how to do that, right? But the moment that we decide to pick up the phone and actually make the call, you know, sometimes it works.
That's exactly it.
Sometimes
these
it works.
Little demons, like when I've had a reading and these people are like very, I mean, this is very edgy. This is pushing the envelope. It's a little female Louis C.K. show. It's a little Fleabag. It's a little
without the Me
Broad
Too,
City
yeah.
For older women. So it pushes the envelope. It's not, you know.
Sure, it's not PG.
Yeah. So whenever I had readings and I would hear this, like, it would just be flat. Those are the demons that eat at me. And we had a showing the other night and it was absolutely fantastic. And it's re-inspired my
joy
invigoration,
for it,
my joy, my self-confidence. To really
good.
Push it, so
good.
Yeah, and we're gonna have a screening on January 3rd at the Slipper Room, and it's so wonderful to see this show with an audience because the roaring of laughter, it's so joyful, and as Kate says, it really pushes the envelope when it comes to the whole dating. you know, it's there's ageism in there, but everything is treated with humor.
Okay.
With outrageous
and,
humor.
And also that women yeah. of our age or people of our age are still alive. We're still, we still have drive. We still have some kind of, you know.
No, but you're absolutely
right. Something
we're not,
to offer.
We're not dead yet. I know.
Exactly.
I say to myself, I was born in 1965, but I feel like I'm 42. I also surround myself with wonderful youth. I mean, a lot of it, right? And like the dewy goodness, right? And they make me laugh, but I learn so much and it helps me stay relatable. But there's nothing better than a conversation of like, been there, done that, right? Been there, done that. And I think that's what makes Messy so funny is when people watch it, they're like, oh yeah, that happened to me. Or,
yes.
Or oh my gosh, I remember when that happened to my friend, right? It's going to be great. I'm so excited for you. And Robin, I know you always have things brewing. You know, what's happening on the horizon for you?
Well, besides the encouragement of everyone to go to the Willy Fest channel on
yes.
Footprint Network and watch Messy, I'm in the midst of the development of a new TV network. Can't
Good.
Really talk much about it because confidentiality agreements. But Donna and I already told you, you're going to be a part of that project.
So excited.
Oh.
And that's something we're going to launch 2022.
Lovely.
Next year.
It's good to have cool. fun things to look forward to, right?
Absolutely.
You know, fun events, working and collaborating with friends again. So I thank you so much for joining us here today. It's the last shoot of this particular calendar year, right? And yet there will be more, right? New things,
yes.
new experiences, you know, more episodes. Hopefully you'll be like writing more things
yes.
and it's going to continue on. So
it's all written. We just need the
yeah,
money.
Yeah, I have okay. 16 episodes. We only had enough money to shoot 5.
Okay, so investors.
Everyone, so.
Investors need to have a
yes.
little reigning greatness.
Hello.
Okay, let's make that sell, right? Reigning greatness.
Reigning greatness.
Reigning greatness. Woo-hoo. We would love to see more Messy. All right, thanks for watching. I'm Donna Drake. And hey, we truly, it is, it's an invitation. If you feel like this is something you can relate to and you want to be involved in the television content industry, this might be your way to participate. Be well.